Welcome back, friends. Today video we are going to talk about distributed tracing, how to implement distributed tracing in our microservice environment. First of all, we need to understand what is a distributed tracing, what we can achieve using distributed tracing. Okay, so this is architecture of flow of distributed tracing. Before that, I will open our architectural diagram. And this is our current architecture diagram. We have implemented this. Okay, only this part is pending, Spring Cloud Sleuth. This part is pending. We'll going to implement part of this video and upcoming videos. Okay. Now, using this, what we can achieve? Using Spring Cloud Sleuth, what we can achieve, that we're going to see now. Let's say the client one requesting API gateway, API gateway requesting report service talking to account service to get the customer data, then customer data giving back to the reporting service generating a report, then that report data giving back to the API gateway response back to the client one. This is the flow, right? Now here we are calling, traveling to three services: API gateway, report service, and account service. Okay, now if any services having some issue, we have to trace the log. First of all, we have to go and see the log, right? What is the issue? If any issues happened, any errors happened, what you have to do? First, we have to go and open the log and then see the logs. What is the error exactly? See, if it is a monolithic application, there is only one log file. We have to open that log file, we have to see that, right? But here we have multiple log files. Each microservice is an individual application. It's an individual application. It has its own logs. Okay, we need to go individual microservices and open the logs and see that. Okay, but in this case, we cannot map which log relevant to particular microservice log. For example, API gateway generate one log. Whenever sender requests, API gateway generate log. Then, whenever sender requests to reporting service generate one log. Whenever reporting service requests to account service generate one log. All logs are independent, right? Not related to each one. But we need to map. Whenever generate one log, I want to map that log data to report service log. See, whenever client requests API gateway, at that time one log will generate. Then API gateway requests to a reporting service, at that time reporting service generate one log. These two log content I want to map. Now report service requesting account service, at the time account service generate one log. Now I want to map these three logs. I want to map these three logs. How to do that? I want to provide one unique ID for that three logs. Whenever sender requests, there is a sequential call happening across the microservice. Each call, there is a one log generating. I want to map all the log using one ID. That ID called as a trace ID. Using the trace ID, we come to know that, okay, this log relevant to this log. Whatever log generated here, that log relevant to this log. That mapping, that relation, we can easily find using the trace ID. If you want to generate that trace ID, okay, we need to use this particular starter project. This is part of Spring Cloud component. We have to add this artifact in our each Spring Boot application. For example, I want to integrate this Spring Cloud Sleuth, API gateway, account service, report service, and the product service. So we need to add this artifact all the application. Okay, I explained all the flow. This is the flow, right? Since we have multiple microservices, the call happen in any manner. In the any manner, the call call can happen, right? According to the use cases. API gateway directly call account service. API gateway directly call report service. API gateway directly call product service. So in all the scenario, we need to generate the log. All the logs I need to map. Each relevant logs I need to map accordingly. Okay, that is my intention. For that, we need to add a Spring Cloud Sleuth. Okay. This is the flow of Spring Cloud Sleuth. Here I'm saying Zipkin client, RabbitMQ, Zipkin server, then Zipkin UI. We're not going to cover this part. We're going to cover only the top one box. Today we're going to cover only the first box, that is Spring Cloud Sleuth. That only we're going to integrate. Other part we're going to integrate in next session. Okay. Now here we're going to see this particular flow. Client requesting API gateway. API gateway request to account service. Account service request to report service. Then report service responds back to the API gateway. API gateway responds back to the client. This is the flow we're going to see. Then some log will generate that. We're going to see how that log mapped. How that log get mapped. That I will going to show today video. Okay. To implement that, we need to add one artifact. For full implementation, for this full implementation, we need to add all this artifact. But today we're going to cover only this section, right? Spring Cloud Sleuth integration. So we need to add only this artifact. Okay. So org spring framework.cloud. Then the starter project is Sleuth. Spring Cloud Starter Sleuth. Okay, we need to add this. Okay, I have opened all the microservices. See, let me start first config services. Let me start config service first. Config service started. Let me start now service registry. That is a Eureka naming server. Service registry also started. Let me check Eureka naming server. See here, config service started now. Before starting other service, we need to add the artifact. So we need to trace the logs, right? So we need to add the corresponding Spring Cloud Sleuth artifact. This is a Spring Cloud Starter Sleuth. We need to add this artifact in all services. We are using API gateway. So we need to add an API gateway. Then sync that. Now and reload. Then go to filter class, action filter. Say here I want to add one log. Okay, just I want one common log. Logger dot info. This is API gateway filter. Okay. I'll go to start this server now. Okay. Then I'll going to account service. The account service also just add that artifact. Reload the project. Then go to account service controller, customer controller. I'll going to show demo using this particular method. Okay, I will call this particular endpoint through reporting service. Okay, so I want to add on log here. Before that, we'll add that logger equal to log factory dot get logger customer log access. Okay. So in the account service, I'm going to call this, right? We'll go and test this method. So I'm going to add the log here, info. Account service calling, fetching all customers, fetching all customers. Okay. Then start the server. Then go to report service. Same thing, just add that Spring Cloud Starter Sleuth. Then sync it. Go to report controller. Logger already there. I want to, I'm calling get all customer API here, right? So I need to test this endpoint. Okay, for that I'm adding logger here. Logger.info. Logger.info. Report service. This is calling account service. This is calling account service. That's enough. Okay. So I need to call this API via API gateway. This URL is we are calling directly report service. Okay. Now my intention is I want to call this API via API gateway. If you want to call via API gateway, what is the URL? http://localhost API gateway port number 8081 slash. We need to mention account service, the service name. What is the service name? This is the service name, right? Just copy the service name, paste it here, then slash. I want to call this API. For that, just copy API slash reports, then finally we need to append this mapping. So this endpoint for calling via API gateway. Okay, let me start this. Let's check that Heroku naming server. How many services are started now? Account service started, config service started, report service just now we started, right? Okay, then product service. The what about API gateway? Already started API gateway. Oh, some error. Okay, let me rebuild it. By the time I'll go and add the artifact in product service. Okay. Oh, sorry. Sync the product service. Also, we need to add some log here also. Okay, logger. SLF 4J. Okay, logger. Logger equal to log factory dot get logger product controller dot class. That's it. In the product controller, I'm going to test with this endpoint. Okay, fetching all products. Logger dot info. Product service, fetching all product. Okay, Now in the report service also we need to provide the same log for the product service endpoint. Okay, before that I will going to start this service. Let me check API gateway started or not. I'll start trying. Yeah, I'm starting the API gateway now. Still it's giving the same. Why? Reload. Okay, now I'm going to report service in the product fetching all products endpoint. I'm going to add the log here. Okay, logger.info. Report service fetching all products from product service. Okay. Okay, now I need to restart. Since I changed it, I need to restart. What happened? API gateway. Start again. Yeah, this time it should start, I think. Yes, API gateway started, also registered into Heroku naming server. Let's check that Heroku naming server dashboard. So in dashboard, we have account service, API gateway, config service, product service, report service. All services are up and running. Now, this is a time to test. Before that, I'll going to clean all the logs. Port service logs, account service logs, then API gateway log, then product service. Okay. The report service, if you want to call, fetch all customers endpoint, what is the API, what is the endpoint we need to do? We need to use this one, right? Yeah, this one. Open the browser. Localhost 8081 account service. We are going to call account service from the API gateway. This is the API gateway URL. From the API gateway, I am calling account service. From the account service, I am calling a we need to call report service. Sorry guys, I wrongly mentioned. This is a report service, right? We need to say report service. Report service. Okay, we have to call report service. If you want to call this endpoint, we need to call the report service, right? So report service HTTP localhost 8081 report service. Then from this is the API gateway. From the API gateway, I'm calling report service. From the report service, I'm calling them this endpoint. This endpoint internally calls account service using Feint client. Okay. So I got the response. Let's check the log now. Go to API gateway. See API gateway, I got the log. See here, this is the API gateway filter. Along with this log, you can see one ID here. This ID generated by Spring Cloud Sleuth framework. Okay, I copy this here. Then let me open account service. Account service also, you can see one log here. Account service fetching all customers. See here also, you can see one log. See this log, both are same. This is a trace ID. whenever send a API request to API gateway, at that time Spring Cloud Sloth generating a one unique ID. That unique ID is shared with its subsequent call. It is next available call. That is next available API gateway calling account service, right? So that account service, whenever generate a log in account service, the same log mapped, same ID mapped. Okay. Now we'll go on to check with report service. Copy this log. See report service. This calling account service. Okay. This is a log. Copy this also. See here. There also you can see the same log. One, two, in the three call you can see the same log mapped. So this log under this log under this log generated in a single request. Whenever you are requesting a fetching all the customer, that time the three request get generated. Three log generated. At that time your Spring Cloud Sloth generating a one unique ID to map all the logs. So through this tracing ID, we come to know that what is the subsequent call for each microservices. Okay, this is the easy way to track the log for particular flow. This is the easy way to track the log for particular flow. But still there is some complexity here. Here we need to go to each services log file. We need to open the each service log file. We need to find that log using the trace ID, right? Instead of doing like this, we can integrate this tracing in a Zipkin server. Okay, if you integrate this Spring Cloud Sloth in the Zipkin server, it will provide on UI. Through that UI, we can easily explore the all the calls. Easily we can explore all the calls instead of opening each application log file. Okay, now I'll go into calls from account services. Okay. Sorry, product service. The product service, I want to call this particular endpoint. For this, what you have to do? The same thing. HTTP colon localhost 8081, this is API gateway. Then we are calling the product service via report service. Right? So we have to say report-service/. Which API you want to call? I want to call this API. For that, need to. So this should I need to do in report service. Sorry. Here, this API I need to call from the report service. Report service call the product service. Okay. So HTTP colon localhost 8081 report service slash. Copy this mapping. Then copy this. Okay, I'll clear all the logs here again. Clear the account service, clear the product service already cleared. Then API gateway. That's enough. Okay, now I'm going to call API gateway. Here I am calling API gateway, then I am calling report service, then I am calling product service. Okay, via report service. Let's see what's happening. Report. It's a typo error. Report service. Yeah, I got the data. I'm calling this API via report service. Okay, I'm calling this data via report service. Okay, the report service calling a product service. Okay, now we'll check the log. Go to API gateway. See API gateway again generated a log with a unique trace ID. Now this time this ID is a different. When I call account service, when I call account data through reporting service, that time it generated one ID. And this time it's generating another ID, right? Unique ID. Now this ID mapped with other services logs. Go to product service. Copy this. Product service fetching all products. See here. So mapped. This is a trace ID, this is a span ID. Okay, this is a trace ID. This is the ID we need to use to track. Now report service. See, for all this log having mapped with the particular trace ID. This is the purpose of Spring Cloud Sleuth. This is a distributed tracing. We are tracking the calls. We are tracking the calls. Through this, we can easily find out issues. And if you want to do any debug, if you want to identify any errors in your microservice, we can use this mechanism to find out the problems. Okay. The next video, I am going to integrate this Spring Cloud Sleuth in Zipkin server. Zipkin server provides one user interface where you can see all the information in that UI. In that UI, you can see all the information. It's easy to find the calls. That UI provide easy way to find the all the calls. Okay, that we'll going to see in the next video, how to integrate Spring Cloud Sleuth in Zipkin server. Okay. I hope you understand. If you have any question, please write a comment in the video description. Definitely, I will go into a reply. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribed this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.